some more trouble with schools. Some students at George Washington University, they want to change their mascot. Our next guest went to find out why students think the Colonials is so offensive.
I mean, colonial is kind of a touchy word.
There's like a negative connotation with the colonials and with colonialism.
There are students on this campus who don't feel comfortable with it, and so then it doesn't really matter what other students think.
The whole like colonial thing is like a little white supremacist-y, and I think like a hippo would be a better mascot.
Joining us now, campus reform correspondent and George Washington University student Abigail Marone. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Those answers, they literally made me laugh. A little white supremacist-y. And also, if someone is uncomfortable, then it doesn't matter what anyone else thinks. Talk to us about this.
Right. So this effort has been going on for over a year at George Washington University. Students have decided that the colonial, our mascot, is offensive. But what's missing in this debate is any sort of common sense whatsoever. There's a huge difference between a colonial, which is our mascot, and anyone who lived during colonial times, and colonialism, which is what students are saying this mascot is representative of, which is not the case at all. Colonialism is a political system of taking over land. But last time I checked, being born during the colonial time and living during that time, there's nothing offensive about that.
Well,
you would think.
You spoke to a few other students that talked about colonialism. Take a listen.
The word colonial like evokes an image of like white men coming to take people's land.
Like, we can't forget that Americans fought for freedom on land that wasn't theirs in the first place.
You know, slavery bad, colonialism bad.
Well, that's it. I mean, is that the overwhelming mindset? And if one person is offended, then everyone has to change what they do.
So at George Washington University, the push for this really is just an aggressive, vocal minority. However, like the Leadership Institute's campus reform has reported on numerous times, oftentimes the vocal minority wins out because they are the loudest and they convince other students that they should be offended by a mascot, which is literally George Washington. That's what our mascot is, the George Washington, the colonial.
Oh, is it that it's depicted as George Washington?
Yes, it is GW George. So these students aren't just offended by the word colonial, which is confused with the word colonialism, which aren't the same at all. They're offended by our nation's founder and our university's namesake, which is really just ridiculous that this is what they're pushing to change.
Right. And it's our understanding that the amount of students who have actually signed the petition is really tiny compared to the student body of 20,000.
Right.
And like you said, it's a vocal minority. But all those kids, the other students that you talked to, had they signed the petition or they just responded that approvingly to when you were asking the question?
So some of the students had signed the petition, but a lot of them also had not signed the petition. However, as is the case on most left-leaning campuses, students feel the need to hop on the social justice bandwagon. If something is deemed offensive by their peers, they do not want to be the ones to push back against it. So some students who had not heard about this said, yeah, I think that is offensive. I mean, why wouldn't it be? And like you heard, one student said, if one person thinks the mascot is offensive, we should change it. I mean, what kind of logic is that?
Abigail, but speaking of their logic, eventually George Washington is racist in their logic, right?
Correct.
Because our country is sinful, and as a result, that's what we're talking about.
Taking their logic to the absolute extreme, you're totally right. And when we asked students this question, some of them said we should change the name of our university, which is ridiculous because without George Washington, we wouldn't even have the freedoms to have this conversation today.
So totally,
take him off the dollar bill. I mean, I can't.
It's the mindset of the left. I mean, he is the founder of our country,
the namesake of our university,
totally.
Gave us
thank
our
you,
freedoms.
Gabrielle,
all right,
great
Abigail,
stuff.
Thank you
appreciate
so much.
It.
Thank you for having
and
me.
And note, we reached out to the GW Student Association for a statement, but have not received a response yet.
Good stuff.
All right. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Teachers in one state may soon be real-life kindergarten cops, the new plan that could turn our educators into officers.
Plus, talk about CalExit. More than half of Californians now say they plan to move out. California radio talk show host Mike Slater here to weigh in on that coming up.